guys, it's Nicole, and this is gonna be a video on what to do when you have an admission when you clock in. Obviously these tips aren't gonna work for every case, but I hope you find them helpful either way. The very first thing you need to do is obviously get report, but the approach is different than normal. Usually when I get report from a nurse, I am trying to get tons of information, extensive backgrounds, you know, POA, why they're here, you know, how are they eating, what's really going on. I'll spend a good 10 to 15 minutes getting report because I want to be prepared. But if I'm getting a rapid admission when I clock in from the ED, I don't need to know all that. You need to keep it short and sweet. I don't need to know about knee surgeries or cataracts from 10 years ago. I need to know what's going on, what have you done, and why are they coming here. If they had an asthma attack, what did they get in ED? Albuterol, you know, what happened? Did it resolve or did you have to do more intervention? Then why are they coming to my unit? I need some sort of resolution. If this patient, you know, had a heart rate of 55, was intubated, what else happened? And then what's the full picture here? Meaning that if they had an asthma attack, you gave them albuterol and they're stable, why are they coming here? Is it observation? Did it get worse? Did they become, you know, status asthmaticus? What happened to bring them to the ICU? Because a lot of nurses know what happened and what caused the change in patient condition, but they don't know why the patient's coming to ICU. If they fell downstairs and twisted their ankle and you thought the ankle was broken, so you got an x-ray and the ankle wasn't broken, why are they coming to ICU? You know, a lot of nurses don't know. If they don't know, that's fine, I'll figure it out later, but I wanna see if I can get that information from them quickly. Very, very short report. I need to know systems, neuro, cardiac, GI, GU. You can tell me sinus tap, alert oriented, positive bowel sounds, and pulses, and that'd be okay with me. I'm not gonna spend a lot of time on this report because I have to get my room ready. Usually as they're talking, I'm getting my room ready. Getting a room ready for a patient with a ventilator takes a good 3 to 5 minutes. I need to get suction, canisters, yonkers, oral care kits. You know, this room has to be set up for me to be successful and for the patient to be safe when they get here. I need to make sure I have a ventilator and a bed. There are many times where I get an admission and there isn't a bed for my patient and they're just sitting in a wheelchair or in a stretcher. Be ready. You have to roll with the punches here. A lot of nurses are upset when they get admissions when they clock in because they aren't prepared, but you have to use your time wisely. Do you want to spend 15 minutes on the phone or 5 on the phone and 10 minutes getting ready? You have to choose what you want to do, but having a good day and having a bad day are dependent upon your perception and whether you're organized or not. So the number one tip is don't stress. Roll with the punches. You know, your manager and bed management cannot control the influx of sick people in your community. So there isn't really a point of you getting upset or you getting mad at your manager or charge nurse because they're doing their job. What are they gonna do, turn the patients around because you don't feel like working right now or you want a light morning and like a, you know, a stressful afternoon? You know, it's not dependent upon your attitude. These patients are going to come either way, so just be prepared and be ready. Number two, get a really short report, make it bare bones. If your patient can't talk and you feel like you have to get an extensive report, ask who the POA is or the next of kin and you can call them and get all the information that you need. But getting a 15-year, 10-year history makes no sense when they're on their way and they're in distress. So keep that short. And the last tip is make sure that your room is ready. If it's a ventilator patient, make sure you have all your tools. If it's a patient who needs an insulin drip, get your pumps ready, get your bag of insulin, you know, scan your documents. Just be ready. But yelling at the ED nurse because they're coming too fast is not going to help you. Yelling at the ED nurse because they don't know the intimate details of the patient's history is not going to help you. In ED, they triage. They don't, you know, they don't have time to look up echoes from 2 years ago. I do that with my patients. They might have been admitted today, but they were here last month or the month before or the month before. So I changed my view date for 2 years. I want to see the full history. I want to know what's going on with my patient for the past couple years when I have the time. When I don't have the time, I'm fixing what's problematic right now, and the ED nurses think the same. But we're all a team here, whether you're a nurse, environmental services, you know, you work in a cafeteria, we're all here to help the patient. So you yelling at each other is not going to get anything accomplished, and it's only going to waste time. Do you have bad days in nursing? I don't. I love every day. Yesterday was interesting. I was doing a 30-minute code and I passed out because I didn't eat. It was 4 p.m. and I didn't eat. That was my fault. Was my day bad? No. Before that, in the morning, my patient told me I was the best nurse she'd ever had, and she'd been hospitalized multiple times. I love it. It made my day. Me passing out was embarrassing on my end because that was my fault. Was my day bad overall? No. Everything in life, whether you're doing nursing, whether you're doing engineering, whether you're working in fast food, is perspective related. You have to think of it in a positive way and it'll be positive. Every day can be negative if you ask the right person, but you determine how your day goes. So don't be stressed, be prepared, get a short report, and you'll be fine. I hope these tips help you out. As always, if you guys have any questions or comments for me, please put them below. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to eat like me and have a good day. Bye.
No, hypokalemia, not metabolic acidosis. Duh.
Wait, I forgot. Are you a nurse?